Today's topic for discussion is description of a specific plant, that is Gossypium herbaceum. This plant is commonly called as cotton and its family is Malvaceae. This plant, it is a very important fiber yielding commercial crop actually, and it is extensively cultivated throughout India and especially in tropical and subtropical regions of the world. And it is very commonly grown by farmers. Let us see all the details of this Gossypium herbaceum family Malvaceae. Habit and habitat, that is, it is a mesophytic plant and it is annual or perennial small shrub. There are several varieties of cotton are present. Even the perennial plants are present. It consists of taproot system. Taproot is branched and stem is, in perennial plant, it is stem is woody, erect, branched, covered with stellate hairs, and stem is solid, cylindrical, brown in color, and it has bark which is brown and fibrous. Let us see how is the leaf. Leaf is simple because the leaf is having only lamina and the stalk of the leaf. Stalk and lamina, only two structures are present in the leaf. Hence it is the simple leaf. Stalk of the leaf is known as petiole. Okay. And leaf is, hence the leaf is simple. Leaf is colline because it is attached to the, it can grow on the main stem of the plant. Also, it grows on the branches of the plant. Hence, it is ramel, colline and ramel. Okay. Shape of the leaf is palmately lobed and color of leaf is green. And stipule is present, hence the leaf is stipulate. Petiole is present, hence it is, leaf is petiolate. How is the venation of the leaf? Veins are present, reticulate venation is present, it is the dicot plant. But the venation is reticulate multicostate divergent. Multicostate divergent venation means there is not a single costa is there. More than one costa, more than one vein is distinct in the leaf. Such venation is described as reticulate multicostate divergent venation. And that occurs in Gossypium herbaceum leaf. How is the phyllotaxy? Attachment of the leaves on the plant. How is the phyllotaxy? Phyllotaxy is alternate. Leaves are arranged alternately on the stem. Okay. Margin of the leaf is entire because it is in continuation. How is the base of the leaf? Base of the leaf is chordate. Okay. Apex of the leaf is again, a leaf is lobed. There are three lobes shown in the photograph. Even in some varieties, five lobes are present in the palmate leaf of cotton. Okay. That depends on the variety. And in the photograph, the palmate leaf is having three lobes and each lobe is pointed or acute. Okay. Texture of the leaf is lightly rough. Next, inflorescence. How is the arrangement of the flowers in the plant? Inflorescence, okay. It is cymose clusters are present in the cotton. Next, this is the flower of Gossypium herbaceum, family Malvaceae. Flower is complete because all the floral units are present in the flower. Floral units means calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium, all are present and the flower is complete. Flower is large, hairy, beautiful, dotted, and the flower is called heterochlamydus. Why the flower is called heterochlamydus? Because in the flower, the calyx and corolla are distinctly identified. They are more distinct in color and texture. Such a flower is described as heterochlamydus flower. and it is a cyclic flower. Why it is called cyclic flower? Because the sepals, petals and stamens, they are arranged in a separate whorls in the flower. Such flower is described as cyclic flower. In the flower, bracteates present. Hence, the flower is described as bracteate flower. Okay? Pedicel is present and pedicellate flower. Pedicel, it is the stalk of the flower, which is known as pedicel. If the pedicel is present, then it is described as pedicellate flower. Symmetry of the flower. Flower is symmetrical. Symmetrical flower is described as actinomorphic. And sexuality of the flower is bisexual. Ovary is superior, hypogynous. Color of the flower is white. Okay, next. Calyx. Calyx is the first oral of the flower. Calyx consists of sepals. There are three sepals are present in the calyx. And the sepals are foliaceous. Foliaceous sepal means they looks like a leaf. Okay, sepals, they resemble the leaves. Okay, such type of sepal, they are described as foliaceous. And the sepals are persistent because even after formation of the fruit, sepals are present at the base of the fruit. Okay. And how many whorls of the sepals are present in the flower? Only one. One whorl. Okay. Color of the sepal is green and the sepals are united at the basal region. Hence the sepals are gamosepalous. Gamo means united. Sepals are united in Gossypium herbaceum, cotton plant. Aestivation is volvate. Epicalyx is present, which is three lobed, fused with deeply cut margin. Okay, next. This is the epicalyx. It is situated below the calyx and it is the modified bract. Next. This is the corolla of the Gossypium herbaceum. Corolla consists of petals and there are five petals are present in the flower. And the petal shape of the petal is ovate. And they are mucilaginous. Mucilaginous glands are present. They are sticky. They release a sticky substance. If we cut it with the hand, sticky substance is present in the sepals or petals. Okay. Color of the petal is yellowish, light yellow. How many whorls are present? Only one whorl of petal is present in the flower. And the petals are free. Hence, they are described as polypetalous. Aestivation is to stay. Next, this is the male part of the flower, that is androecium. It consists of stamens. There are many stamens are present in the flower. All the stamens, they united at the filaments of all the stamens, they are united and form a tube-like structure around the style. Such a united stamen, there are many stamens, but they are united and forming a tube-like structure around the style. Such a stamen, such a condition is condition of stamen is described as monodelphous. Mono means one. Monodelphous condition, because all the stamens are bound together in a single bundle. Such condition is known as monodelphous. It is a very specific characteristic feature of family Malvaceae. Attachment of the anther, it is transversely attached to the filament. Okay. And how is the anther? Extrose or introse? Anther is extrose because when the pollen grains mature in the anther lobe, naturally the pollen grains are released at the peripheral region of the flower. Okay. And anther is monoecious. Only one theca is present in the anther lobe. It is a monothecous anther. Dehiscence of anther takes place what? Longitudinally. Hence the dehiscence is longitudinal. Filament of the anther is very delicate, yellowish in color. It is thin and whitish. Okay, next. This is androecium and gynoecium shown in the photograph. And next. This is the gynoecium of Gossypium herbaceum or cotton plant family Malvaceae. Gynoecium, it is female part of the flower. Gynoecium consists of ovary style and stigma. Position of ovary is superior because the floral units are originated or grown from the base of the ovary. Hence, it is superior ovary. Carpels, 3 to 5 in number. That means tricarpillary or pentacarpillary ovary. Okay. The carpels are united, hence united carpels are there. Hence it is described as syncarpus. Okay. 3 to 5 loculed ovary with many ovules in each locule. Such type of arrangement of the ovules is present. And placentation, attachment of the ovule means placentation. It is axile placentation is there in plant of Gossypium herbaceum. And stigma, as many as carpels. Okay. Style, simple. Next. This is the fruit of Gossypium herbaceum. It is a loculicidal capsule. What is capsule? It is a dry fruit which split open into several definite sections. It develops from bi or multicarpillary gynoecium with superior ovary. At maturity, the fruit opens by valves or the pore. Okay, such a type of fruit is described as capsule. And how is the seed? Seed is hairy, dark brown to black in color. Okay, next. Thank you very much. Save trees, save earth.